tactician of the Toronto Argonauts back to kick. Wants to run now. And now wants to kick, but drops the football. Hamilton wins by a field goal. Remember 1976, Iverwind Stadium, last game of the season. Hamilton, Toronto. Chuck Ely throws deep to the goal line. His intended receiver, Mike Eben. He loses the jump ball. Hamilton wins again. Remember 1978, Iverwind Stadium again, last game of the season. Hamilton, Toronto has Alvin White at quarterback. Nobody open. And again, the Toronto Argonauts throw their playoff hopes away. But this is 1980, Iverwind Stadium, and again the last game of the season. Again, it's do or die for the Argonauts against the Hamilton Tiger Cats.
As we look down on Iverwind Stadium, the scene of this afternoon's last game of the 1980 regular schedule in the Eastern Conference between the Toronto Argonauts and the Hamilton Tiger Cats. Every team in the CFL Eastern Conference is deeply involved with what happens in this football game this afternoon, and nobody will know until this one is over where they are going to be and where they will be playing the final game and the semifinal game.
It was in Toronto. There was a lot of problems with regard to the officiating as to whether Toronto really did deserve to lose that game to Hamilton. And here we've got it this afternoon. First place is at stake, and the last playoff spot's at stake. So you couldn't ask for anything better.
The Argonauts in the 1970s got blown out five times in their bid on the final day for a playoff spot. Most people say that's a jinx, but I understand you don't agree with that.
No, Don, I don't really think that it's a jinx. I look back and I think when I was playing with the Ottawa Football Club, and we came in here and many times we're fighting for the first playoff spot with the Hamilton Tiger Cats. And I'm a firm believer when you get down to these sudden death football games, that when you go into the home stadium and you're playing against a solid football club, they have a definite advantage. And I feel that that's been one of the situations with Toronto having to come over here and play Hamilton so many times in the last game of the season.
Well, there's no question with Hamilton's tough stand against the run, the Argonauts will have to pass. Mark Jackson is their quarterback. He has thrown 16 touchdown passes, but given up a like number of interceptions. Dave Marler has also thrown for 16 touchdown passes. He shared the job in Hamilton and has given up only 7 interceptions. So an outstanding defensive player in this team. He is a real hitter, Anderson. He comes from Oklahoma via the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Interception right there for Anderson. He will be facing the Argonauts rookie nominee, Dave Newman, who was not expected to make this team out of Missouri. He's become their top pass receiver with 10 touchdowns catches in this 1980 campaign. There's one last week against the BC Lions as the Argos won to keep their playoff hopes alive.
Situations with the snap going over top of his head, the Tiger Cats did not actually have a block on. They only had two men coming from the outside to contain Z, and now
he's on blocker and gets taken down at the 33. Brought it back 17 yards. Waves breaks the middle and gets across the 40-yard line. Preston Corkendale, high formation, second back through is Ovi Graves. He'll have the first down for Hamilton. As he gets up near the 45-yard line. Has him around the 47. He's backed up by Danny Bass, who actually made first contact with him. And the gain there is going to be just a couple of yards for Hamilton.
Well, that time, good defense by the Toronto Argonauts. They had 11 men within 2 or 3 yards of the line of scrimmage with one man back, Billy Hardy, as the safety. And they're anticipating Hamilton's going to try and run that ball a little bit at them early in this ball game.
14 yards, Argos' best containment of Graves and his 3 carries so far in that last play. Second down and 8. An obvious passing situation for the Tiger Cats. Oh, early movement. Right side of the Argonaut line. The pass gets off anyway. It is blocked out there. Lieutenant Lee Patterson. Argonaut. Graves cutting outside with some room. Inside the 45-yard line goes Ovi Graves. deep. Holland cannot get it the second time around. Ron Meeks was covering in number 17. Holland got a second chance as the ball deflected but could not capitalize.
Another offside. Miscavige jumping in there, but there was not an offside. But Bruce Black, who had an excellent game 2 weeks ago against Hamilton, gets a pretty good lick at Marler after he got by Ed George, but you can't blame the offensive line. There was plenty of time for Marler to throw that ball downfield.
He just paid the price, that's all.
You're going to wait that long, you have to expect to get hit.
Second down, 10, 42-yard line. Marler can't find a receiver this time. He bails out to Graves at the 34-yard line. He'll be up following Ruoff's field goal. First down. Newman in motion right. Mueller going left. Rolling and throwing is Mark Jackson. Complete to Dave Newman. He fights for and I think got a first down right there at the 45-yard line. Another quick pop to Newman. Deflected. And it goes incomplete. Falling shy of the would-be interceptor over there at the far side.
Play the strong side, and you can't do that when Peter is lining up in the backfield.
Here's Newman coming out of that backfield. He has got himself 5 yards. That is Walker. At least for the 50-yard line, it's going to be 5 yards shy. Third and five to go. Toronto now. Position, ready to punt. Hangs one up in the area of Obie Graves, the 22-yard line. He reaches the 30 and then ducks down around the 33 for a 10-yard return. Decide first and third place in the CFL East. Obie Graves again. Threads his way through beautifully. Getting up near the 39-yard line. Not good for the better part of 7 yards. Gordy Judges, the ex-Montreal Alouette, number 75, took him down. First quarter. Graves again. A penalty marker has been thrown. He would be up very close to a first down. Through to the shotgun goes Dave Marler. He's got effective in the last few weeks. He is going to go long. Left side. It is just too far for John Holland. RD and Newman go back around the 30-yard line to receive this punt from Bernie Ruoff.
Got a pretty good wind going with him there, too, if he gets it up high enough.
So first indication of what the following wind may do. Swirls around inside the 40-yard line, and Newman. Newman can't find any room. Goes all the way outside to get some, and then gets a couple of yards as he slides across the 40. And out of 4-0, the Ticats over the Argos to this point in 1980. First down, Toronto at the 42-yard line. Their own. Mark Jackson had it all close in on him and just got back. Perhaps not quite to the line of scrimmage. Wayne Smith was there and Jim Ramey. It's a second down, about 11. Argos shopping for the first conversion. They go way down here. That's too far for Greer at the 20-yard line. He was in behind Randy Graham. Terry Greer was and came oh so close to hauling it in.
Well, he got in behind there and he was wide open. We see on isolation the good coverage on the outside. But he gets hit real hard in here now after he's thrown that ball. And you could almost call that too late. But the defensive player, number 68, James Ramey, was in there. And he came close to having a face mask off.
He had 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. 5-0 Hamilton. Good kick against the wind. Coming down to Dave Shaw. Stumbling a bit. Now getting in full flight. And finally reaching the 29-yard line. Their aspirations for playoff survival hinge on the outcome today. Hamilton going for first place if they could win this ball game. They lead 5-0. Marler rolling with room. Can't find a receiver. Now a flag is dropped. Could be holding Hamilton. Marler gets out across the 35-yard line. Smart
going to come in here. Willie Martin has been moved to that guard spot. Right there, number 54. You can see Martin hanging on to him because it was a rollout to the right. And Clark got the outside position on Martin. And the only thing Martin could do is hold him. And the referee was right there to call it.
Minutes, 15 seconds until the end of the first quarter, and here comes Clark again. Way too early as red flags dot Argo Wind Stadium.
Well, last year.
He got away on them. He's had a great season here. Great last half, especially. On the sidelines, the coverage there by Meeks very tight on John Holland. It is incomplete. Put it on field. Leif Pettersson, a would-be receiver, had fallen. Another indication of offside Toronto as Marler cannot escape the pocket. These teams almost jumped again. Goodman did, got back in time. Here's Marler swinging it out to Obie Graves. He gets one block, but that is all. He's torn down inside the 30-yard line. 5-0. Here's the charge, and he has it away in plenty of time. Coming down to Newman, the 40-yard line. Backs up a step. Into forward gear he goes and takes it up for 8 yards at the 48. And then some pushing and shoving. Newman. Here is Mark Jackson bailing out. Throwing, complete, good catch by Greer, and he finds the first down marker and then some. Gets inside the 45-yard line, the Hamlin 42.
Well, Ben Zambiazzi is there now as we come back to the play after Jackson has scrambled all over the place, and they never quit out there. You can't, because Randy Graham Zambiazzi had to make the stop.
Toronto's best field position of the day is 7. It's the right defensive end for the Hamlin Tiger Cats.
Boy, that's a Mutt and Jeff situation, isn't it?
Yeah, a little bit. Or as most people against Wayne. Jackson on second down and 6 will go long. In the corner. Too far. Flag for interference. 1 yard line. It'll be first down Toronto. It's Greer. Got tangled up with Leroy Paul, or vice versa. But there's another penalty flag down near the line of scrimmage.
Don, the big question is going to be what's back at the line of scrimmage. There's probably going to be a holding call. That's what we've got, a holding against Hamilton. Illegal.
No, sir. Second down and 6. Jackson out to Newman. He overthrew him. Anderson covering him at the 22-yard line. A couple of Schenley nominees going head on that one. He puts it up beautifully. 3 points, Toronto. And resistance. Graves, and Clark wrapped him up in a hurry. He read that all the way, and he came from the left side. Had to veer to his right to get Graves going in the opposite direction.
Commercial with the three-pointer. It's 5-3 for Hamilton.
Second down and 13 as Myler fires right. Good coverage, good catch out there. The 42-yard line. 40 on by Andrzejczyk. Third down and 3. The punt, a good one into the wind by Bernie Ruiz. Coming down to Billy Hardy at the 22-yard line, giving up ground to gain some. And he's got a lot of room. Billy Hardy at center field. One block might do it for him. Billy Hardy, they're not going to catch him. Hardy takes it in for a Toronto touchdown. Officially 88 yards. If you're wondering about the longest of the year, that's 102 by Dave Shaw, the Tiger Cats, September 13th against Montreal. Jackson holding, presented and resistant, and it's through. The 88-yard punt return for the touchdown by Billy Hardy.
Well, again, you talk about how things happen, but the key situation is when that man who doesn't catch the ball does his job, and that has to make Willie Wood feel a lot better. He's kind of a...
And he wants to desperately.
But number 32 is the key, because he's going to get Blair. He's the contained man, and once he knocked Blair out of the play, Hardy went right behind him, waited for him, and then Ruoff was the only man up there. There was no hope for Ruoff. He didn't make much of an attempt.
A little bit of a tackle on Ruoff, I thought, on that block. It was Phil Jones, number 12. Graves inside the 5-yard line with the win. It comes down to about the 6-yard line for Marco Simtar. The 20, the 25-yard line, that'll be all for him. Kobe Graves. And he was prevented from cutting outside for potentially good yardage by Mike Williams. A diving shoestring tackle broke that play out. Close to call for a lot of people. Second down and 10. Marler with, again, plenty of time. It's tipped away by number 14, Mike Williams, his second big play in a row. 12 and a half minutes to play until halftime. Ruoff hangs it up beautifully into that wind. Not a terribly strong wind, but a swirling one. Here's Newman. He picks it up recklessly. And the Tiger Cats have it at the 33-yard line.
He's the first man downfield. You can see he does a good job of containing Newman. And Newman, for some reason, just as Zambiazzi hit him, it didn't seem like he hit the ball, but whether Newman hit it with his own knee and knocked it out, and it popped right to number 41, Blair.
Toronto. Tyler puts it up.
Patterson playing in his first ball game this year, the first regular season ball game, split the seam down here, got between the two defensive backs, and Marler almost underthrew him. He almost gave the defensive backs time to come over and knock it down.
He makes it 12-10, Hamilton. A two-point lead for the Tiger Cats. 12 minutes and 3 seconds left until halftime. What a game. Hope you're enjoying it. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this. Now, Hamilton has gone on top, suddenly 12-10, and has regained momentum here after the Dave Newman fumble, the touchdown to Patterson. Here's Terry Greer on the run. The 30-yard line will be all for him. Argonauts will start right there. Little mix up there. Nolan for Jackson to hand the ball to, and he's struck down inside the 25-yard line. Taylor made the big hit, number 6.
Angle shot here is the quarterback. You see all the maze of players around, and he's trying to just ad-lib something as a problem developed in the offensive backfield.
About 11 minutes until halftime. That is Greer, and he's contained there, short of the first down. Here's the rush. He can't get it away. He made a motion to pass. He didn't know what to do. As the support for him broke down completely.
Now the Tiger Cats are coming here, and this man is just going to come in here, James Ramey, and he's going to have a free go in there as he comes through. And there he comes right up the pipe, the two of them, and they put all the pressure on Z, and Z just didn't punt that ball, and Hamill gets second big break in two series.
Muller made him turn away into the path of his teammates. They downed him easily, so from the 21-yard line, Hamilton with a big break. They'll likely go for the distance again, as he did the last time. Into the end zone, Patterson, oh, just taken away by Billy Hardy, as Patterson is about to put the... Obie Graves gets away from Clark, then tripped over his own blocker. After three from the 27-yard line, angle right, and he kicks it through. First down, the 35-yard line. To Walker, here's the pass, and he's saved by Woods. Harold Woods at the Toronto 40.
Turn the ball over three times in a row. You've got problems. This time Woods playing the outside safety spot, moved in front of the intended receiver and picked it off. A zone defense. Mark Jackson did not see number 6 Harold Woods at all. Ramey, number 68, does a good job of putting on pressure and puts more pressure on Jackson than the
team's interception Jackson has given up this year. Obie Graves into a big crowd, comes out of it very well, gets inside the 35-yard line for into the shotgun formation. Marler up the middle, has the first down. Six.
Here comes the blitz.
And the pass is almost picked off. It is picked off. It came loose, but Toronto has the interception. It's whistled dead at the 19-yard line. The official right there rules Toronto ball. And the Hamilton fans, along with John Payne, not exactly enthralled by that call.
Now John Payne doesn't have a very...
Here it is. Sinclair, the receiver. Derek Martin, the defensive back. Look like a tie.
And you can see them fighting for it. They ruled to have possession long enough, and they gave it to Martin.
Wow. So here is Walker across the 20-yard line for only a couple of the 21. to Peter Mueller, and he fights for what appears to be a first down. Walker's racked up early. He got himself a yard and a half. It was Jim Ramey, the left tackle, number 68, who knifed in to get him. 10th for Toronto right here. 8 yards to go for the first down. Against the grain, the screen pass to Elliott Walker, who cannot get successfully outside, as only three, and the Argonauts will have to punt the ball away. Two of his attempts today. Here comes the rush again. Heading for the sidelines, out of bounds. Hamilton will take over at the 26-yard line. As the support again for end position breaks down, Jim Muller, number 69, got his hand on the football. There he is. Four important turnovers in this quarter for the Tiger Cats.
Well, again, one of the situations you can't have is that man over the middle letting him penetrate as he is, and somehow Jim Muller, number 69, on two successive punts, has been able to penetrate right back and push the deep.
15-10, Hamilton leads. Obie Graves will test the right side and fights for a couple as he gets inside the 25-yard line. Inside the 50-yard line, he would have the first down. John Payne couldn't ask for more from his defensive special teams that he's had today. We have two penalties, holding Hamilton offside Toronto, the early indication. Care who wins. Those are the petals off Miss Ticats, the flowers she was wearing. They're having a feast on. Ticats having a feast on the Argonauts in terms of scoring opportunities right here. Just under 3 minutes to play. Marler over the middle, 20-yard line, but short of the first down. In just a moment from Arbor Wind Stadium in Hamilton. If Ruoff can make it from the 27-yard line. Into the hands of Phil Jones, and he gets pushed back into the end zone. They rule he was outside the goal line, and the Argonauts are going to start around the 1 yard line.
But things like this do happen in games when you've got a lot of pressure. Little penetration. Ruoff did not get the ball up in the air, and the ball was partially blocked.
Maybe this will show us who was able to get through there.
Well, good penetration from this side over here is where the problem develops. And they come through, and Ruoff does not get the ball up in the air.
Kevin Southwick coming through on that one. Argonauts, Walker at the 5 yard line, takes it across the 10, push down. And a big seconds to play. Jackson almost had his head taken off out there.
No angle. Carl Cornell has always been known as a linebacker who likes to take the good arm shot when he's tackling, and he gets called for a face mask quite often. That time he really put the hammer on Mark Jackson.
Well, back to Walker again. He hits out close to a first down with the wind behind him.
That's true.
So that is the first down, as you saw. 1:38 remaining now. Jackson pops it out here. Mueller dives ahead and spills the ball out of bounds up around the 27-yard line.
Well, I can't see the...
Way over on the left side. And it'll be a first down around the 37-yard line. Paul. Walker cannot escape a good first hit from Luke Player, the veteran left corner linebacker, number 39. Good catch by Peter Mueller, but he will not have the first down. He was...
Now, this is an interesting call for Coach Wood after Peter Mueller made a good catch of a middle screen. Again, he's coming out of the backfield.
The utmost of support from his blockers in the last couple of attempts. Zeman and Resition. Just away that time. Gordy Patterson fields it for Hamilton around the 49-yard line. And Resition, who took what I thought to be a bit of a dive, gets up very slowly and walks away with no penalty call.
I think there's no question about that he took a little bit of a dive, but what I think has to be of concern for Toronto is that they've got two little guys back here blocking, And these people just are not doing the job because the penetration is coming. And when the penetration comes, they're just coming right through there. And you can't have Hardy back there trying to block a guy 260 pounds coming at you without the offensive lineman taking a shot at him first.
Opie Graves gets out for about four in any kind of hurry. Graves takes it to the 50-yard line with 3 seconds remaining, but a penalty flag is down.
Interference, Hamilton number 65, second down over.
Cats will likely take whatever they can get here. And they are going for it all. But it's out of bounds, the catch made by John Holland of the Argonaut dugout. And that will take care of the first half as the gun sounds. Hurricanes. Here's Orby Graves. Into his own blocker and then into the Argonaut wave around the 17-yard line. As Dave Marler handing it to Obie Graves. The Argonauts trying to find a way to solve him. They've done so partially in the latter part of their first half. And now Dan Bass takes him down around the 21-yard line. Hamilton at 15-10 as we are just underway in the second half of this game to decide first and third places in the CFL East 1980. If Hamilton wins, they'll go ahead of Montreal and have a bye to the final. If Toronto wins, Montreal will finish first, and the Argonauts will make the playoffs with the Ottawa Roughriders missing it for the first time in quite a while. It is lobbed up, interception. That's a dangerous zone for Patterson. Billy Hardy got a free one right there at the 35-yard line.
Put it up there. Patterson was open, and I don't think he ever thought Hardy could get out there with him. He threw it up there. Hardy, just like a receiver running an out pattern, got out there to take it right out of Patterson's hands, but he laid it up in the air a little bit. If he'd thrown this on a line a little bit more, no way Hardy could have got there to make the interception because Patterson was wide open.
That was a shot put. Puts him in the lead in that department, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I think with 11, and that's
35-yard line. Here's Walker getting in for five as he kind of... Greer on the sidelines, got turned around. He was overthrown at the 20-yard line. It is incomplete. It's 7-yard line. Angle right on the hash marks. And he's got it up and through. And it's two for two. And he brings Toronto to within 2 points of Hamilton. The only difference now, the not conducive to throwing, that's for sure. Here's Obie Graves. He fights hard. It's early November afternoon. Marler's got Patterson wide open. He got crunched hard. Good hit by Phil Jones at center field, but it's a Hamilton first down.
They've got a receiver that wide open. Bass, the middle linebacker, went to the right hook zone, and Patterson coming in from that right-hand side.
Their quarterback of today and of the future, Obie Graves. That's five more to his total as he hits the Toronto 50. Duncan McKinley tackled in number 52, the left corner linebacker. So they're halfway to a first down, the Cats, with a two-point lead, 15-13, 4 minutes and 20. He's calling an automatic right there. Over the middle, it is complete to Patterson. And the Argos have not solved him today. He was hit down by Mike Williams inside the Toronto 35. It is another first down for Hamilton, a 15-yard gain. And Patterson is a little slow getting up.
Well, exactly the same play he caught before. He wasn't as open quite as much this time because number 14, Williams, was there with him. But the point was that there...
You can see some of those... Well, you can see some of those pom-poms to the left of the Toronto Argonaut dugout in the bench area. Those are the Toronto cheerleaders from the Toronto Argonauts. And Harold Ballard, when asked if they could go on the field and parade up and down in front of the crowd, nixed that idea, so that's the best they could do, is get up into that area. They've been noisy, though.
They've chosen strange colors as Toronto cheerleaders. There's Graves at the 31-yard line. He's got about four. Well, those young ladies are dressed in Hamilton colors. Yep, they are right next to the Argonaut bench. Maybe the leader of that gang is colorblind or something. Sutton has stayed out. Labette is still in his spot. Here's Marler. The rush now comes on, and it is tipped. And incomplete. Both these men, Ruoff and Andrews, issued deadly on field goals today. But this time, Ruoff is wide. And Hardy will give up one to increase the Ticat lead to 3 points at 16-13.
To say that time,
not a great deal. Mark Jackson, sideline pattern. Good hit there on the sidelines by Jerry Anderson on Dave Newman. Nice couple of Shinley nominees. The team is Jackson. And here comes the penalty for him. There. And secondary blocking zone. But they get the job done. Comes out to Dave Shaw. Back to the 50. Center field. Look at him go. Shaw scoops inside the 40-yard line. A big punt return for Hamilton. That's from the Toronto 37-yard line. They lead 16-13. Another good scoring chance right here on Shaw's 37-yard punt return. Here's the pitch to Roby Gray. Stepping over people. 30-yard line. The Toronto 23. First down again. He brings one in from John Payne. Argonauts move early. It is Graves getting inside the 20-yard line on it. And they go outside. The 18-yard line. Leading by three. 16-13. Long count. Flag flies. Marler puts it down. 6-yard line. Complete. A good strike to Craig LeBette. His first catch today. So many scoring chances for Hamilton. Here's Blair Shallow.
Procedure. Hamilton, number 71.
Nate Pedersen.
Once again, the 23-yard line. Marler got hit as he threw, and it goes nowhere. But a penalty flag is down to the 10-yard line. Interference, the indication against the Toronto Argonauts. If so, it'll be first down, Hamilton, and will be, as it appeared Danny Bass interfered on the play.
Number 14, first down.
Find Mike Williams. He's been going to the inside. Notice how Williams took the inside away from him because he has been going to the inside. It was not.
First down, Hamilton. Fumble. It is a free ball, the 5-yard line. Toronto. Now it is Hamilton coming up with it at the five. Obi Graves got on top of that ball somehow with Argos all around him. And they gained 5 yards out of it. Six.
You got to put that one in the offensive playbook and find out an easy way of getting 5 yards.
Simply a bad exchange from center to quarterback, and they get 6 yards.
Well, 20 of the guys out there didn't even know where the ball was.
Marler hits for the major score as John Payne reacts. Gordy Patterson, what a day he is having. Number 34.
The key out here, and again you can see Bass favoring going to his right hand side, and I'm not really
obviously in some pain. He can't put very much weight on it at all,
probably ligaments. It's kickoff
and it comes down bouncing in front of Terry Greer.
You better get on it,
and he does just in time, but gets virtually no run back out of it. Greer was shaken up on the hip by Reddle, Doug Reddle. As Greer writhing around down there, as you can see, at the 24-yard line. Problem. Toronto will have first down for the 24-yard line, trailing by 10 points. 23-13, as they wait for Greer to get all the way across and out of the playing area.
That Alan Moffitt injury at the dugout area. Has been diagnosed as a twisted ankle right now, so he might very well get back in here.
Mark Jackson puts it out of bounds. Bob Gaddis, almost a forgotten man today, the Argonauts' best receiver over the season, has not caught a pass. In fact, that's as close as he's come to catching anything today, and that was out of bounds over his head.
To try, too. They haven't got much left in the season.
Yep, getting low on cards to pull out of here. Here's Jackson going for the home run ball to Gaddis. He almost had him. It slipped through his arms to the 35-yard line. Good coverage by Paul.
Good protection for Jackson. Paul actually knocks it away, but Jerry Anderson looked like he might have an intercept. He seemed to misjudge the ball and lost it as he had to turn around. The ball was thrown downfield a lot further, I believe, than Anderson anticipated, and it was Paul.
As Anderson stands inside his 10-yard line. Here
he's
in. Down, but he's got it away nicely. A good kick. 43-yard line for Dave Shaw. And a run back by Shaw is across midfield of the Argo 53.
That's number one, and especially they like doing it right in front of the Argonaut bench.
Obi Graves is run down for a loss. Shy of center field.
Come on.
punts it out to a wide open receiver. Simcox being run out of bounds. He may have just missed a first down as he's driven into the wall over there on the far side by the Argonaut defender. Should be short yardage for Hamilton when we come back. Stay with us. Time he's getting out there. It's tipped. Intercepted. Williams. Mike Williams is across midfield at the Hamilton 53-yard line. And it can turn that quickly. Are you in that middle? You in the middle of all that?
Pop. Pedersen going downfield, tries to run that curl in again, and this time the middle linebacker had done a job of faking as though he was going to go to his right-hand side, and Bass came over and he tipped it, and that was the key to Williams making the intercept. He did not overthrow him. It was actually tipped by the middle linebacker.
Look at the way he carries the ball, though. Finally, tucking it in just in time. The 53 and a half of Hamilton. Draw play. Locker, good yardage with it. That fooled the Cats. Is inside the 45. Fakes the draw. Against the grain, goes back to Walker. He escapes one tackle. May have some room now. He reaches the 35-yard line with a... Walker got cut down. Good play by Hamilton there as again the Eagles fail to convert in a key situation.
Now, low angle, the play hardly gets on track here as they try and run the ball on the second down and three situation. Carl Cornell, playing up tight, did a good job of coming in and making the tackle with Watson.
Position so hot, take three and see what happens. There's the three. The wind-assisted field goal by Andrzejczyk makes him three for three on the day. And so at the end of the third quarter, first down, lead by a touchdown. 23-16 to begin the final quarter. Good fake to Graves by Marlowe. He puts it over the middle. It is complete at the Argo 50-yard line. Good catch by John Holland. I think that's his.
He's been running Graves in there on first down almost every series of plays. This time he gave him a little hand fake, put the ball on his hip and hit it. Allowed Holland lots of time to get downfield and beat Meeks over the middle. And again, that seems to be the area that Hamill's working on, straight down the middle.
A 26-yard gain. Take the Graves again. Sideliner is dropped by Sinkar. Marler steps up and gets through. He's at the 40, the Toronto 38. Ball came loose, but I believe it's whistled dead. Hamilton recovering in any event out of the 35. Marler appears to have picked up the first down.
The middle linebacker getting a better drop. You can see him dropping straight back now instead of favoring one particular zone. Does a good job here. Marler fakes him to the right and comes back. Bass getting a hold of him, stopped him from going a lot further.
Graves got all wrapped up early. They broke down his blocking. Well, bad exchange again. The Argos have come up with it at the 46-yard line. Last time Clark made the recovery, the last time that happened, the Cats gained 6 yards out of it. This time, Bruce Clark was there to win the turnover for Toronto, and a big one it is.
Well, the ball never gets up to Marler. He seems to be moving away, didn't ever get a hold of it, and it bounced right over to Bruce Clark, and unfortunately for the offensive player, he never knows the ball is loose. The defensive guy has all the advantage.
So Toronto wins it at the 45 and a half yard line. They go first down. Sidelines. Gattis juggled it and they ruled no catch. It's deflected. Anderson turned the wrong way. He's had six today. His longest is 40, well below his average of 45 plus. And he line drives this one. Takes a Toronto bounce near Shaw, the 28-yard line. And Dave Shaw is wrapped up across the 30 by Terry Greer. A 36-yarder by Andrzejczyk.
Good job right there of really putting the blocks to Peter Mueller.
Hamilton from their 32-yard line. Obie Graves, who else out of that backfield running with the ball, gets up near the 39. Second down, about four. Graves again, first down and then some. Pops it out for first down. On Hamilton Cameron. As he gets good pass blocking and fires it. Knocked away beautifully by Williams. Overmolton leads. Tyler goes long. He's got Patterson and overthrew him by a step inside the 25-yard line. Again, not that you want to hear. Here is R.D. from his 10-yard line. Away from Waschuk, and then finally taken down to the 18-yard line. Carl Quinnell made the stop. A good 51-yard wind-assisted punt by Bernie Ruoff. Anderson has been hurt on that play. Number 17 for the Ticats. But and out to the sideline. So line, they're all knocked out is the word. This is for Peter Mueller. Could not find an opening. And then he is almost strangled by Jim Ramey. Have it for you on CBC television. Jackson has to bail out. Swing screen pass to Walker. And Walker gets up close to you, but just short of the first down. And I don't know, Russ. You may have to gamble right here. Or what do you think? 7.5 minutes left. They stay in there, ready to go. About a half yard for this crucial gamble for the Toronto Argonauts. Jackson appears to have it. He gets over top of the pile around the 29-yard line. And the marker was inside the 29.
Well, we'll find out close. Exactly here. Let's
this
see.
Could be close. I think he's still got it, though.
Oh, I think he's got it. Oh, he's got it by the whole length of the football. What are you guys talking about?
My goodness. Why would anybody be concerned about a thing like that?
Now, that is the gamble of the year right there.
Yep. The Seagulls are hovering here. Jackson wide open. Has got Pearson as he hits out of the 50-yard line. Tom DeMelfer, Hitchcock, Ruby, just get out here in Hamilton. There are all kinds of birds flying overhead.
They're not buzzards. Well, they might be. Depends who loses.
Well, Pearson there, and then moved back to the outside and beat Cornell for the big first down.
I'll tell you another thing he did. He held on to that football. That was his prime concern. He didn't want to fumble.
He was going for Greer at the Argonaut bench of the sidelines. Leroy Paul was covering. Jackson got a good hit as that ball was released.
Well, in the first half, Hamilton was saying, we're here and we're coming after you. And there was a blitz situation on, and Zambiazzi, the linebacker, got free to the inside.
The second down conversion for Toronto.
Here they come again.
Jackson gets it up. He is, out of the hands of Bob Gattis. Paul covering him. But there's a penalty marker down. Gattis certainly had that ball within his grasp.
Paul beat. The ball is thrown out in front of him, but he just doesn't shield away far enough. See how he's turned his body? A way to give Paul a chance to reach in and push the ball away if he would have had the big reception.
And position has it away. Dave Shaw, 35-yard line, up to around the 43, an 8-yard. Yep, there's Graves. You can be looking for him. In this situation, takes it up for about 3 yards, reaching the 46. As Tom said, a tie means both these teams lose. At least they lose what they were going for. John Payne's team would be tied in points at Montreal, but after second, settle for second place. And the Argonauts would lose their bid for the playoff spot, a point behind Ottawa, if they should finish in a tie. It's 23-16, Hamilton right now. And Graves on that carry, reached the century mark. 100 yards in 24 carries today.
Defensively on that line of scrimmage.
Marlowe can't find a receiver. He will take a loss on the play.
The backs are playing. Derek Martin, number 29, is just pushing him all over the place, saying, I've got position on you.
Takes the clock down to 4.5 minutes. Hard line drive spiral down to Newman. He's at the 10-yard line. Heads for the sideline. Cuts up and reaches the 25. A good hard run back by Dave Newman. Newman in motion right. Up the middle goes Walker as he gets it out to about the 31-yard line. Not a bad call. The Cats looking for the throw, and they run with Walker into Mueller, 69, the tackler, and get more than halfway to a first down with a gain of 6.
Walker gives the impression all afternoon that he hasn't played a great deal this football season. He's running, as we might say, a little tentatively out there and not making those quick moves that I'm sure he normally would do if he'd been playing a great deal.
third. Does not quite get the first down. He's a good yard, maybe more away.
We got all that popcorn around here, and they're just looking for those empty popcorn bags.
I'm surprised to see one of these quarterbacks hit one of these things. The pass. They are getting a little low, some of them. Here's Andrezician set to kick. It's been a good ball game. It's not for the birds, if that's what you're thinking.
Good center.
3.5 minutes left.
Good
and
pass.
A tremendous putt. His best today. Drive Shaw, and a good catch back at the 23-yard line. And Shaw is tracked down right there. So Hamilton will start from the 26-yard line as Andrezician comes through with a 53-yarder. And I'll tell you, that almost got away. The Cats at the 26-yard line, leading by a touchdown, 23-16.
Guess who's carrying the ball?
Let me figure out who it is. It's Bobby Graves, of all people. There goes Graves. Blocked by Jones near the 45-yard line, but he... There's Graves, another first down. He grinds them out, doesn't he? The Argos know what's coming, but they can't stop it. Graves to the 50-yard line. And so the Ottawa Rough Riders and their head coach, George Brancato, must be ready to send Orby Graves a little token of their appreciation because he is exercising the ball control, as you see there.
Here they come.
Here's Orby.
Good call.
Look at him go. There's a good one. Graves to the 41-yard line. Bill Jones finally tracked him down as Patterson has scored the two touchdowns. He's a happy man over at the Hamilton bench.
Well, you have to like this call by Marner. The blitz is on. The Argonauts are coming. But look at the way Graves set it up. He started out to that left. Don McKinley, number 52, who is coming up the middle to go to his left. And all of a sudden, he's got daylight up there because he's by the linebackers. And lo and behold, the defensive backs, this time Jones, had to make the stop.
First of Toronto. Powell ahead of Graves. The ball goes to Graves, of course, and he's stacked up this time near the 40. He only got 2 yards. While it is getting dark on this early November afternoon, it is getting very late in the football season of the Toronto Argonauts. With a minute and 17 seconds remaining, Hamilton leading by 7 points and grinding out the time and the yardage here in the waning seconds. The timeout means the clock starts now. The snap of the ball. Marler fakes to Graves, carries himself. And he picks up the first down. That could be it. The 30-yard line.
A good fake in there. Graves fakes in there and really gets hit as Marler faked to him and then turned to the outside. And you can see how much Marler wanted that first down.
Here he is one more time. Twisting his back in for as many yards as he can get. He gets about 3 of them. Receivers to the right side.
That's it. Keep it yourself. Don't fumble it. Run some time out. Don't fight.
On. 21-yard line, 20 seconds remaining.
And he can run it out on this play. Without putting the ball in the air or kicking. Well, the only thing you would criticize Marler for here is his overenthusiasm as a sophomore quarterback because he's fighting for extra yards now. At this point, don't start trying to beat McKinley and spin around because they're trying to do one thing, the Argonauts, that's strip the ball from you. Get down on the ground.
Get down and stay there. So, as Russ suggested, with 20 seconds remaining, the allotted time to put the ball in play, they can kill it without having to worry about a thing. Down to 9 seconds.
He can just run back and kneel down.
Directly in front of him. He knows how long he has to put the ball in play. He'll snap it on 1 second and take the victory right here. Hamilton is going to finish in first place. The Argonauts, yet again, miss Eastern Division playoffs in the CFL. It'll be Hamilton hosting the winner of the Ottawa Rough Riders and the Montreal Alouettes semifinal game. And John Payne has his team in first place after a topsy-turvy season. Perfect execution by the Tiger Cats, led by Dave Marler and Obie Graves, to hold the ball in the final moments. The final score, 23-16 for Hamilton. We'll be right back.